we learned almost instantaneously after this shooting outside of Dallas that this person was some sort of Nazi, was a big fan of right-wing content and everything. And in theory, that might provide an opportunity for some of the most extreme figures on the right, those who regularly advocate for violence, to think, maybe there's consequences to this. Well, maybe not. Because have you considered the alternative to self-reflection, which is just saying it's a false flag? It's much easier on the mind, and simple-minded people find it very appealing. Here's examples of that. When we find out that this guy has spent years posting on right-wing sites, Cat Turd, who I've learned over the past year is one of the most important influencers in the world, posted most obvious psyop ever. And you might wonder, wait, why is it the most obvious psyop ever? Well, it's actually not complicated to figure out. Because it makes the right look bad. And that's it. That's the whole thing. That's why it's a psyop. It doesn't look good for them. And so it probably didn't happen. Now look, Cat Turd hasn't been implicated in any of this. Obviously, Tim Poole is gonna be a bit defensive because this guy apparently was a fan of his or whatever. So he posts that it's obviously a psyop. Again, not explaining why that is, other than the fact that it's an inconvenient reality that this person liked a lot of figures on the right, not just Tim Poole, but a bunch of them. He goes on to say, by the way, almost echoing in some ways stuff that Aida was saying recently, we need to figure out what the issue is in our society, in our culture. I genuinely believe it's dissociation. It's a dejected society where individuals don't know or care about each other, and they seek validation or they seek to push some extremist ideology. And I largely agree with that. And it's good to see that sort of message coming from Tim Poole, who has never pushed for people to hate each other or hate other groups in America. You know, he's not an active participant in a multi-year war to get every single white conservative American to believe that the mere existence of a trans person is an existential threat to their entire way of life. He'd never do anything like that. None of them push racism or misogyny or xenophobia or anti-Semitism. None of them contribute to the feelings of social isolation that he's talking about right there. My God, how convenient it is. But it goes beyond just the Tim Pools. Literal geniuses are convinced that this is a psyop. So a crazy person named the redheaded libertarian, who I think is involved with the Blazer, Alex Jones, it doesn't matter, whatever, was posting that. Because Ian Miles Chong, who just posts about American politics or whatever, says that this guy is posting this right-wing stuff. She says it's a psyop. Elon Musk responds, this gets weirder by the moment. But does it get weirder? As we find out that the guy who obsessed over guns and wanted to kill a bunch of people was a Nazi online. Is that weird as we get more details? It's worrisome. It's concerning. It might be depressing. Is it weird though? It's only weird if your goal is not to understand what happened and stop it from happening again, but make sure that the right comes out of this without looking any badder than it's gonna. Then maybe it's weird. How are we gonna deal with this anyway? Of course, he's not a genius. He's a complete moron. I will, before I toss to Aida for comment, I will just leave you with this thought. If it's a psyop, that means the FBI did it, the CIA did it, whatever. Depending on which crazy person online, they'll say a different one. So then you probably should ask yourself, they're not going to, but you should ask yourself, why? Why did the FBI make a multi-year fake history of Nazism online for this guy? Why did they give him a gun? Why did they have him shoot a bunch of people? And they actually, some of them have an answer for that. And that answer is to take away our guns, you see. That's what the false flag is for. You do this shooting and then you take the guns. However, this isn't my first day doing this show. I've been around for, I don't know, 30, 50, 100 times that they've said that exact same thing about past mass shootings. And so I'm left wondering, so when are they gonna take the guns then? Because the FBI has gone to a lot of trouble to kill a lot of Americans to justify stealing guns, and they just keep forgetting to do it in the end. It's just a big oopsie daisy. I guess the paperwork got misfiled or something. They did the terrorist attack and then they forgot to actually ban the guns. Isn't that weird, Aida?
Yeah, it is. You forgot the martial law step before they take the
guns. That's true. That's true. They keep forgetting to do a martial law.
It's coming. It's coming. And we got to get ready. You know what I think is most concerning to me is that they had a whole thread of tweets about their conspiracies about what is happening behind the scenes of this shooter, but not one to express any sympathy for the people who lost their lives. And it's just because when you think about someone like Elon Musk, people are cattle to him. And those are the people who show up at his place of work and they get exploited so that he can be cool on Twitter. I've actually been in a room with him and opted not to meet him, but to watch the way people idolized him and wanting to be in his presence was embarrassing for me, because especially people of color who line themselves up with capitalism in a way that is, capitalism has benefited greatly from slavery. It has been driven, you know, slavery was driven by capitalism, because capitalism and white supremacy are like twins. And so it's just so funny to me to see people just rush and wanting to be in the presence of someone like Elon Musk, because it's aspirational, the American dream, without even thinking about the story behind him with apartheid and what happened in South Africa and how people acquired their money. That being said, I'm on a tangent, I know, but it's just amazing to me how so much was put into the conspiracies behind this stuff, but no one ever expressed any type of compassion or care for the people who lost their lives and the people who have to live with that wreckage.
Yeah, 100%. I have not been in a room with Elon Musk. It probably wouldn't go well. But I will say, this is my theory. Not a single one of his cultists would accept this. But I have always thought, I think one of the reasons that these people love people like Elon Musk and Donald Trump is they don't want to worship truly impressive people who work hard and accomplish great things and think outside the box.
Yeah.
They say that, they pretend, they create this aura that that's what it is. But they don't want that because that's hard. It would be hard to do that. It would be hard to be that. But if you could reach the top and be thoroughly mediocre, well, then there's hope for me. I could potentially do that. I could not be charismatic. I could not be funny. I could not be clever. So I think they secretly want that, Aida. It really is. There's a reason that conservative ideology is as hierarchical as it is. I've been talking about that a lot recently. There's a reason that they want a hierarchy for everything, okay? They want a racial hierarchy where white people are top. They want a gender hierarchy where men are at the top. Same for being cis, same for being straight, same for being all these things. Because the good thing about a hierarchy, assuming that you're in the good category, is that you are already the best. You didn't have to do anything except be born. It is the appetite for successful mediocrity that demands a system where you've already won. And if that could be buttressed by the best, biggest people also being as mediocre as you know deep down inside that you are, well then reality seems like understandable. Success seems achievable. I think that's why they love this stuff.
Yeah.
No, I apologize.
No, absolutely. You're 100% correct. I don't know if you are 100% correct, but I totally agree with your point of view. How about that? I'm trying to be smarter in how I express it, because I think that the people who are out there who are willing to do the most ridiculous and egregious things are the ones who get angry, because they believe their opinion is law, and if you disagree with them, then you are the enemy.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.